The rain is here again, and the people of Onne, in Eleme local government area of River State, one of West Africa's richest industrial community, are beginning to panic as they prepare for the coming of the flood. What you are seeing is a barricade built to prevent the flood from entering this house. But unfortunately, the owner cannot drive in or outside of his home. What a tragedy. Some community roads and compounds will not be accessible through this period, as the popular railway area in the community, a known water passage, have been blocked by the increasing activities of some of the leading giants in the Oil and Gas Free Zone Authority. This, according to the natives, is the root cause of the flooding in the community.
Okay, so the cost of it was as a result of this wall. When they extended from their normal boundary down to this place, they blocked the whole water channel and the water flow, because normally water has its flow how it gets out of the community. But when they did this extension, they blocked the water flow, so we had to drag them to make a drainage system for us.
When Intels wanted to help us, I was in a meeting in the palace of His Highness, Chief Jedo Savanna. We told them, channel this thing to the river. He said, no. Channel this water to the river. He said, no, that they will bring it into the borrow pit. And who owns it? Indo owns the borrow pit. They channeled it, all the water in Onne, to this place. How do you think it will work? Most of the times it overflows the bank and bounce back. And we, along the channel here, we'll be in trouble. That is why you see I barricaded my frontage. My car does not get into my company anymore. Because each time, good, if I will show you, you see the mark of water on that of August. That is the mark of water here. That is down 3 feet high. Then when you talk of the parlor, is here. So the borrow pit cannot carry. If Prodeco and Intels have listened to us, and this thing was channeled directly to the river, we would have gotten problems. Because the volume of water coming out of the community through this channel is too much, too voluminous.
Yes, as you can see for yourself, look at this place, it's my own access road to my compound. The essence of me barricading this place for the blockage of the water coming into my compound. That's the essence. Even doing so, this thing alone cannot even hold the water, the flood. In my compound, every time rain falls, there are a lot of flood. If you get to my parlor, I open my door and show you my parlor, what this thing have damaged, you will run away, this water have damaged. The possibility of doing this thing that we can never be affected is to get a long drainage down to the water, to the sea. We have that if you go behind this way, there is a place we used to go, they call it lay, we have other places, other water side, you know, so there's a place that this whole thing can be digged like a long drainage down through the farm road.
While some narrate their ugly experiences, the concerned youths of an air community, Comrade Egbe Gospower Sunday, who embarks on a periodic evacuation of this failed drainage system, he believes that if the stakeholders and the multinationals can synergize and revisit this prone site, this bedeviling issue will be resolved and the community will move on to a new page.
I think Prodeco and Intels in collaboration did this drain some years back, about 6-7 years from today, and their finishing point was very poor. As you can see, the tunnel that is carrying the whole of the water out of the community is not a concrete tunnel. They just digged a pit, channeled it to a borrow pit, and by the day, we all know the pressure of water. This thing keeps collapsing. Just as you can see, it collapsed by the day, and there is no proper security around this drain system. So even the debris from the community, people keep bringing debris here, and we've given it some temporary measures over time to ensure the water flows, like the tunnel from the borrow pit. Always we do 3 months clean up there to make sure we remove the debris for the water to flow, but we need to give it a long-lasting solution by making sure we incorporate the stakeholders and the multinationals, most especially the people that designed this pit, so that they can come back and correct these things to enable the water flow out of the community properly. If we can get a concrete tunnel, because even the discharge point is lower than the tunnel we have here, so we've kept on digging this other side of this channel, so the water is not going from the discharge point because it's higher. It has been filled with sand and debris. And so I would advise, if the company can come back and make a proper concrete tunnel from the community down to their own side. Even the one taking it down to the river from inside Intels is just normal digging, and it's also collapsing too. So imagine when it has collapsed and is filled, the whole water backflows to the community and keeps damaging people's property.
Well, I think if we put our heads together, work as a team, work as a community, we meet back the company. They are not yet gone. They are still there. Even if they have dropped most of their work, there are still skeletal workers there. Their engineers are there. We can draw their attention to it. You get the point? Sometimes you will see immediately after the flyover, the rail, you will see that left side of it, water so much, it does not even enter into the tunnel or whatever they did there, you know, to take the water into the river, as they said. It becomes stagnant there. Yes.